没有搜查令，警察到底是否可以强行进入私人住宅？今天我们来看一个发生在美国的特殊案例啊。索菲亚是一位单亲母亲，她独自一人带着2岁的女儿居住。今天家门口来了2位不速之客，是2位警察。警察想进屋跟她谈谈，因为警察说索菲亚白天喝醉了，然后躺在地板上，而她2岁的女儿只穿着一只纸尿裤到处乱跑，甚至跑到了门外。警察认为索菲亚家庭状况太差，对孩子不够负责。他们想给孩子申请社区护理服务。
So I've got these officers keeping their foot in my door right here. They're entering my house without any permission against the Constitution. You are. Actually, I need to throw away a dirty diaper. So here are the officers, and they're violating my constitutional rights. Here's one. Here's another one of them.
Can you get your camera on my face, please?
No. You're in my house, so if you don't like it, you could leave.
Well, we're here for the poor living conditions of your children.
Yeah. I thought you were here because my 2-year-old apparently was running around.
You were. That's the initial contact.
And then you came in my house without my permission.
We're a Community Caretaking Act.
You came in my house without my permission against the Constitution.
We're here because of the living conditions of your children.
Mm-hmm.
That's why DCPP is out here.
Mm-hmm.
You're found sleeping on the floor, highly intoxicated.
Can you please move your foot or no?
警察的目的是进屋跟索菲亚谈谈，为孩子申请社区护理服务。显然，索菲亚很不乐意，她只想把警察赶走，而警察就是不走，而且把脚放在门口挡住门。他们为什么要把脚放在门口？如果把脚拿开了，索菲亚就要把门关上，那样就连索菲亚的人都看不到了。而现在索菲亚一直在告诉警察说他们侵犯了自己的宪法权利。的确，根据第四修正案的规定，没有屋主的同意又没有搜查令，警察是无权踏进人家的地盘。
I was sleeping on the floor. Do you have me on camera?
The person who found you.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
You're highly intoxicated.
I would love to see the video.
We're walking in this back parking lot.
Yeah.
Barefoot and only wearing a diaper.
Mm-hmm.
That's why DCPMP is involved.
Mm-hmm. You have it on camera?
We do.
Okay, well then, do what you gotta do.
And that's why we're here.
Get out of my house.
No, well, you said do what we gotta do, and that's why we're here. And that's why you're being combative with us.
That's fine.
Do you want our badge numbers as well?
Sure, I'd love it.
I'm 138.
728.
Just so you know, you're being recorded as well.
That's good. I'm perfectly fine with being recorded. I don't do nothing wrong. Y'all are the ones right now. Right now, this guy's got his foot in my door against the Constitution, won't even let me close my door. This guy right here. Scaring my daughter.
Don't worry about it.
Go away, guys. Yeah, I know. You're trying to sleep.
现在2岁的女儿也跑出来，她希望警察快点离开。对她来说，警察是陌生人，无论家庭状况有多么糟糕，妈妈始终是她最亲的人。然而，警察并没有离开的意思，依然把脚放在门口挡住门。
You hear her? She said, "Go away, guys. You're bothering her." She wants to sleep.
You put her to bed.
She can't go to sleep when there's strange men at her door.
We're here talking to you.
She was asleep.
About their health and well-being.
Well, then you should have came when it happened if it was so serious.
You did come when it happened. I was here and I spoke with you.
And you left.
Yeah,
because nothing was wrong.
Okay.
All right, well, now you need to move your foot out of my door because this is unconstitutional. I'm trying to go sit down. It is unconstitutional.
You can go have a seat.
You will lose your badges.
Go right ahead.
I don't need to go have a seat. I'm not going to have a seat while you're standing at my door.
You have a seat.
No, I did not.I have it on camera. You're funny.
All right. I'm glad you're starting to come around and seeing our point of view.
Yeah.
索菲亚的家里的确是脏乱差，这对于一个孩子来说肯定不是良好的成长环境。警察认为索菲亚没有能力照顾好孩子。社区护理服务的意思就是政府拿出人力财力帮你照顾孩子，这本来是一件好事。那么索菲亚为何不同意呢？其实在美国有一部分人对这种社区护理服务并不支持，他们认为服务质量不好。另一方面，索菲亚还是不想让别人来照顾自己的孩子，就像很多人不愿意把自己家的老人送进养老院一样。
What's your supervisor's name? I want them to come out here.
Sergeant Martin.
Martin?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Would you...
Call him out here.
Okay. 138-0100.
You don't have a warrant. You can't be in my house.
We don't need a warrant.
This is a legal entry.
You
do need a warrant. Oh, so you don't need a warrant to come into somebody's house.
No. I explained to you why.
Your sergeant's going to love that.
Okay.
You do need a warrant. Get the f*** out of my house.
That's a great language to speak in front of your children, by the way.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
I can do whatever I want. I have, you know, you take an oath to uphold freedom of speech. I can do whatever I want. This is great to pull in front of my children while they're asleep. Make them wake up so
we're
you can see them.
We're here because of you.
You said you needed to see my kids. I brought them out, and now you won't get your foot out of my door.
Well,
because of me, what?
I told you what was going to happen.
You guys came in my house without my permission. I'm not even being...
Sophia 一直在强调警察侵犯了他的权利，没有搜查令，这就是非法侵入，这是违反第四修正案的。而且有很多美国人认为啊，警察这种行为比较严重，武装人员非法侵入私人住宅，在很多州都是重罪。如果说的再严重一点，房主很可能掏出武器进行自卫。那么警察今天这么做也是有理由的，他们到底该不该这么做，我们放在最后讨论。
Being disorderly. Came in my house without a warrant. That's illegal.
It's not.
You do, and you don't have to lie to me. I have cops in my family, okay, sweetheart?
Not a sweetheart.
Don't care. Like I said, constitutional rights, I can say whatever I want. You take an oath to uphold that. Can you get your foot out of my door?
No, no.
Now you're just going to keep it there? Against the Constitution. Illegal entry, right here.Right here, this guy right here. Legal entry. You just want to sleep and they're bothering you because they won't get out of our house and respect our constitutional rights.
My supervisor's on his way, ma'am.
That's wonderful. Oh, and this guy's got his foot back in my door too, even though I keep asking them to get their feet out of my door because it's against the Constitution.
And which part of the Constitution states
that? You can't come in my house without a warrant.
Okay, I already explained it.
Your supervisor's going to explain it to you.
Explain it to me?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's going to let you know. It's okay, honey. I know. I know. You want to sleep, but these guys won't let you.
We're not keeping your children up.
Yes, you are. You woke them up and you're keeping them up because you won't leave. I'm asking you to get your foot out the door so I can go fucking lay her down, but you won't let me. You are keeping my children up. You want to say that again? You're the one who made them wake up. He's saying he ain't keeping my children up, but they won't get their foot out my door.
We're about to wrap up.
警察主管没等来，却等来了另外一个女人。这个女人是类似于儿童保护服务中心这种机构的工作人员啊。她在中间协调了一番，表示索菲亚的生活状况的确不好，这对孩子的成长很不利，建议索菲亚把家里收拾一下。她还说明天可能会有义工过来帮忙干活，反正大家伙的目的都是为了孩子好。
Okay.
He said that my kids are getting taken. Is that true?
I never said that.
He did. He said, my kids are going to get taken. And they won't, right or wrong, they need a warrant to come in. They can't have their foot in my door.
Whoa.
My daughter's really scared right now, miss. Look, I'm a good mom. I'm not a shit mom.
Sophia 把这段视频上传到网上，引起了网友的广大讨论啊。很大一部分人认为警察的这种行为属于非法侵入，放在很多州都是重罪，但是也有一部分人持相反的态度，他们认为警察的做法是正确的。虽然警察没有搜查令，但是警察发现了孩子有明显和直接的安全风险，这足以满足紧急情况的要求。在出现紧急情况的时候，警察是不需要获得搜查令就能进入住宅的。就警察脚踏在人家门口这件事到底是否满足紧急情况的要求，如果非要争个是非，这种情况通常都会上法庭由法官裁定。在这里我们再插播一个特殊案例啊，就是关于警察没有搜查令就进入住宅的事情。2001年7月23日凌晨3点钟左右啊，犹他州布里格姆市警方接到报警，附近有人聚会扰民， 警局派了四名警察前往事发地点。到了住宅外面，警察通过栅栏的缝隙看到里面有两名未成年人在喝酒，于是他们走到后院，通过窗户看到屋子里有人在打架，警察决定进入屋内进行制止。当他们进入屋内的时候，看到里面的人还在打得不可开交，连警察的声音都没有听到，于是警察将几个人都逮捕了，指控的罪名是未成年人扰乱治安和醉酒。不过后来这些打架的人把市政府给起诉了，理由是警察没有搜捕令的情况下进入住宅，侵犯了他们第四修正案的权利。他们的律师表示，实际情况是当警察进入住宅时，里面的人已经停止了打架，警察看到的打架已经是收尾阶段了，而且邻居报警是因为扰民而不是因为打架，所以警察是没有理由进入住宅的。当时犹他州法院判决警察没有合理理由进入住宅，但是市政府对判决结果不服，把案件推上了美国联邦最高法院，诉讼双方争执不下，打架方辩称只有在生命危险的紧急情况下，警察才可以不持搜查令进入私人住宅，而市政府方称，如果当时警察不果断采取措施，那么很可能会造成进一步的伤害，警察是为了制止暴力升级才进入住宅的。到了2006年，也就是事情过去的五年后，美国联邦最高法院九名大法官做出了一致裁决，警察目睹了打架，在没有搜查令的情况下进入住宅是合理的。所以说，在美国，警察没有搜查令进入私人住宅，是否满足紧急情况的要求？如果双方有争执，通常都要闹到法庭上去，甚至会闹上联邦最高法院。好了，本期的视频就到这里了，感谢观看。